this here and, have a battery backup here. You pull this out. Activate the battery. Let's see how it's looking. There it is. But anyway, you pull this out to activate the battery. It says remove tab to activate battery. Pull in the direction of the arrow until solid black bars can be seen, so, well, that didn't want to come out. And the battery compartment. Doesn't seem to want to open, so we'll just plug this in. So you got oh, this little thing poker works really good on this.
Does it?
Yeah.
Good. Oops, that was
oh, can you see how to pull this thing? I don't know how to open the battery compartment on this one. It looks like somebody. Something fell on it and hit it. I am wondering something might have fallen on the package.
Jesus Christ.
There it is, all right.
No, I'm assuming that tab's got to be pulled.
Yeah, that's what the pull tab was supposed to snap that off, and it didn't.
They're right here.
Okay.
It says it's supposed to be off?
Yep, that little paper, there's something on it that says to pull until the little tab goes. This just plugs into here like this. Oh, this has got a lot of stuff on it here. And this part, we gotta scrape the sheetrock mud off and the putting up the ceiling, the compound got all over everything, so you gotta scrape all that off.
neutral, the red is on the orange, and the black is on the black, and it's the live, so now we can okay, I'm going to be ready to move into the bedroom here in just a minute. Okay, yeah, hold these up here, get them up out of the way so that the top of the detector doesn't hit anything. And we'll just line this up. And just turn it, and it is locked into place. Detectors come with adapters in case they have a different style plug on them, so I'm going to take this one off. Scrape all the sheetrock compound off the plug here. Brian, you know what I would have done? I would have put a piece of masking tape over the end of all the plugs.
What's that?
I would have put a piece of masking tape over these plugs.
Yeah, I know. Tom just went and did it.
Oh.
I told him to do it, but he obviously didn't listen.
Oh.
Make
and see how that does. There it goes, it snapped in. And I just push it up here, make sure my wires are up in the box so that they don't hit the bottom of the detector. Just put it in. Turn it until I hear it click.
So David, you like my new truck?
Yes, it's a nice truck.
What? $350.
Nice. So you gotta put the ring up here. I found a couple screws. Don't want to over tighten them because you'll break it. And we'll pull our tab here again. And we'll pop it in. Now I'm going to test it and see if the rest of them throughout the house go. So we will pull this tab forward here. The direction that the arrow is pointing. That unseals the battery. And we'll poke all the sheetrock mud out of the holes. This one didn't get it too bad. Snaps in all the way. And I'll just fold my wires up into the box. Make sure we're up above the top of the detector there. I'll give it one more little push. Make sure it's down in all the way. Stay on there, turn it. Hear it snap and lock. I'll just get a
Alrighty. You are the man.
required in new construction and in existing construction, and they are a very good idea to have. So that is how smoke detectors are plugged in here in the country I'm born in. These are bedroom and residential smoke detectors. They have the battery backup in them. Peace. Thanks for watching.